For today's video, we'll be taking a look at what could possibly be the only AMD X870 micro ATX motherboard offering currently available on the market, the Gigabyte X870M AORUS ELITE WIFI 7. Featuring support for the latest Ryzen 9000 series of processors, as well as the Ryzen 8000 series of APUs, the older Ryzen 7000 series of CPUs, and potentially AMD's next generation Zen 6 processors that are likely to be on the AM5 socket, let's take a closer look at this board to see if it's any good. To recap, AMD launched its Zen 5 Ryzen 9000 series of processors back in August last year, and the high-end X870E and X870 chipsets for the AM5 platform back in end September 2024. January this year then saw the arrival of AMD's mid-range and entry-level 800 series chipsets in the form of the B850 and the B840. The X870M AORUS ELITE WIFI 7 that we have here belongs to the AORUS series of gaming-oriented motherboard offerings at the higher end, and I'd say that this board in particular is targeted at folks looking to build a high-end AMD AM5 PC in the micro ATX form factor, who also require high-speed USB 4 ports as part of their PC. With that in mind, the board comes in a box that has an AORUS Eagle motif emblazoned on the front. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll take a closer look at these specs later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALK Tech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. Let's have a look at the contents of the box. First up, we get a Wi-Fi antenna that comes with the new Wi-Fi Easy Plug connector that makes connecting and disconnecting it from the board a breeze. Right, let's set aside the board to see what else Gigabyte has included with it. First up, we get two SATA 3 cables. And these are accompanied by a G connector that simplifies the process of hooking up your PC's front panel connectors to the motherboard. A nice accessory to have, I must say. Moving on, we get a metal AORUS case badge, like so, where it also includes adhesive tape on one side so that it can be stuck onto your PC case. Moving on, we get two packs of rubber pads that can be used to add additional support for your double-sided or single-sided M.2 drives. We also get a multilingual installation guide like so. And to round things off, a regulatory information leaflet. In terms of aesthetics, we see that Gigabyte has gone for a black colored PCB and black heatsinks that feature splashes of grey and some touches of mirror finishes. The board comes with an integrated I/O shield design, and over on the rear, we see that Gigabyte's included some AORUS motifs for added visual interest. A nice touch, I must say, in spite of the fact that most of these motifs would likely never see the light of day when the board is installed inside of a PC case. Fans of integrated aesthetic LEDs for their motherboards will be pleased to note that Gigabyte has included addressable RGB LEDs beneath the chipset heatsink. This then brings us on to the board's VRM heatsinks, which are decently sized, and Gigabyte has included 14+2+2 power phases with 60 amp power stages. In case you're wondering, the X870M AORUS ELITE WIFI 7 uses a 6-layer PCB design. Moving on, the X870 chipset has a single chip design, and the said chip sits beneath this passive heatsink right here. For M.2 drive cooling, Gigabyte has included a single large rectangular heatsink that provides coverage for the two M.2 drive slots that this board comes with. For memory support, the X870M AORUS ELITE WIFI 7 comes with 4 DDR5 slots that, as of the time of publishing this video, comes with support for up to 256GB of RAM and the DDR5 8200 standard. In terms of front panel USB connectivity, we get a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C front panel header next to the RAM slots, and near the SATA ports along the side edge of the board, a USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A front panel header that provides support for up to two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports. We do also get two USB 2.0 front panel headers along the bottom edge of the board, with each header providing support for two USB 2.0 Type-A ports for a total of four ports. Some interesting features to highlight. Back at the top of the board, we get a reset button that's also termed a multi-key button by Gigabyte, which can be reprogrammed from within the BIOS to serve other purposes. We do also get a power button that can be used to power on your PC, as well as a set of status LEDs that can help with troubleshooting PC startup issues. Moving further down, right next to the 24-pin ATX power connector, we get an onboard HDMI 1.4 port that forms part of a feature that Gigabyte calls Sensor Panel Link. Sensor Panel Link is a great quality of life feature that taps on the trend of end users having a small LCD display screen, that's also known as a sensor panel, as part of one's PC case so as to display vital PC statistics or even static images or animated videos of their choice. The said port supports a maximum display resolution of 1920 by 1080 at 30Hz. Moving to the bottom edge of the board, we get a TPM header for an optional discrete Gigabyte TPM module, a traditional 2-pin reset header that you can hook up to a reset switch, as well as a clear CMOS header. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a premium-looking PCIe 5.0 X16 slot for a graphics card. The said slot sports Gigabyte's PCIe UD Slot X design that reinforces the slot for use with heavy graphics cards, where we even get a metal backplate on the rear of the PCIe slot for added reinforcement. As can be seen, the slot also comes with the PCIe Easy Latch Plus feature that helps make removing a graphics card from the slot less of a painful affair. We do also get a full-length PCIe 4.0 X16 slot that operates at X4 mode. Do note that PCIe 5.0 is only supported when you have a Ryzen 9000 series or a Ryzen 7000 series processor installed. It's worth noting that the Ryzen 8000 series of CPUs and APUs only support the PCIe 4.0 standard. For your storage drive needs, Gigabyte has included two SATA 3 ports, with both ports in a right-angled configuration so as to aid with cable management. For M.2 slots, the board comes with a PCIe 5.0 X4 M.2 slot, as well as a PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slot. Do note that both these slots support NVMe SSDs only. M.2 SATA drives will not work in any of these two slots. We've got two quality of life features with the M.2 slots. First up, the M.2 heatsink features a toolless design called M.2 Easy Latch Click, which makes removing and reinstalling the heatsink really easy. Next up, we've got M.2 Easy Latch Plus, which makes installing and removing a M.2 drive a toolless affair, like so. Again, do bear in mind that PCIe 5.0 is only supported with a Ryzen 9000 series or Ryzen 7000 series processor. The Ryzen 8000 series of APUs and CPUs only support the PCIe 4.0 standard. For audio, Gigabyte has included a higher-end Realtek ALC1220 audio codec. In terms of wired internet connectivity, the board comes with a Realtek RTL8125D chip that provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, while Wi-Fi support is courtesy of a Realtek RTL8922AE Wi-Fi 7 pod that supports the 160 MHz channel width and also serves up Bluetooth 5.4 support. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with 6 fan headers that are located in these areas of the board. Also included are 3 Gen 2 addressable RGB headers, as well as a single 12-volt RGB header located in these areas. Let's talk about the rear I/O of the board. The X870M AORUS ELITE WIFI 7 goes for an integrated I/O shield design, where the said I/O shield also comes with ventilation openings like so, in the form of parallelogram shapes. The board comes with a clear CMOS button, a QFlash Plus button that allows end users to update the board's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM, or graphics card. 4. USB 2.0 Type-A ports. 4. USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports. A HDMI 2.1 port that supports a maximum resolution of up to 1496 by 2160 at 60Hz, as well as 2 USB 4 ports that also support DisplayPort video output with a maximum resolution of 3840 by 2160 at 240Hz. Moving on, we get a 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet port, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports, with this port here supporting the QFlash Plus feature, Wi-Fi antenna connectors with the new Wi-Fi Easy Plug design, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. To sum up, the Gigabyte X870M AORUS ELITE WIFI 7 seems to be pretty much the only micro ATX AMD X870 motherboard offering on the market as of the time of producing this video. If you're looking to build an AMD AM5 PC in the micro ATX form factor and require high-speed USB 4 connectivity for your devices, this board is pretty much it. It's worth mentioning that there are similarly spec'd AMD B850 motherboards in the micro ATX form factor, which, by having the B850 chipset, does do away with the USB 4 controller, but in return, you get, say, dual PCIe 5.0 x4 M.2 slots instead, like with the Gigabyte B850M AORUS Pro Wi-Fi 7 that I did a video on some weeks back. That board has very similar specs to the X870M AORUS ELITE WIFI 7 in this video. Ultimately, which board to choose will really boil down to your personal requirements for your PC build. If built-in USB 4 in a micro ATX AMD AM5 PC build is what you're looking for, then the Gigabyte X870M AORUS ELITE WIFI 7 motherboard is clearly your answer. And in that regard, the board comes with a pretty good set of features for a somewhat high-end motherboard offering, where it comes equipped with a VRM setup that should handle the entirety of AMD's AM5 processor lineup with ease. PCIe 5.0 support for both a graphics card and an M.2 drive, 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet with built-in Wi-Fi 7, a good assortment of USB Type-C and Type-A connectivity options, along with a whole bunch of interesting and helpful features such as sensor panel link, Easy Latch Plus, and so on. Some downsides to mention: the board uses a Wi-Fi 7 module that doesn't support the full 320 MHz channel width that you tend to get with higher-end Wi-Fi 7 modules. This is something to take note of, especially if fast Wi-Fi 7 networking is one of your key considerations. Also, I was kind of surprised to see only 2 SATA 3 ports with this board, though if you're not intending to install that many SATA drives in your PC build with this board, this would be a moot point. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.